All right, let's take a look at question number 7. We are to find f prime if f is the absolute value of 3x plus 2. Okay, so there are two possible solutions you can have for this, the derivative of this function. So the first one, I'm going to be using the differentiation rule, ddx of the absolute value of u equals u over the absolute value of u du dx. Okay, this is one possible way of finding the derivative of this function. Okay, so solution one, we're going to be using this formula right here. We're also going to be applying the chain rule. Okay, this is a composition of two functions. It is the composition of the absolute value function and the linear function. Okay, so we have f of g of x equals the absolute value of 3x plus 2. Okay, and we know what the chain rule is, right? So if we want to find the derivative of f of g of x, so f of g of x prime is equal to f prime of g of x, the derivative of the outer function evaluated at the inner function, times the derivative of the inner function. So we are going to apply the chain rule here. So let's see what we have. We have, let's decompose this composite function. Take out f. F of x is the absolute value of x. That is the outer function. Now the inner function is g of x. G of x is 3x plus 2. Okay? Now we're going to proceed to find the derivative of these two functions. Now the derivative of f prime of x is x over the absolute value of x. The derivative of g prime of x is 3. So what we're going to do is find f prime of x evaluated at g. So we'll just simply take g and plug it into the x's in f prime of x, okay? And then multiply it by g prime of x. So f prime of x is simply going to be f prime of g of x is instead of x divided by the absolute value of x. So we're going to have 3x plus 2 taking the place of x. So we'll have 3x plus 2 divided by the absolute value of 3x plus 2. Using the chain rule formula, we are to multiply this result by the derivative of the inner function, g prime of x, okay? So g prime of x is 3, so just multiply this by 3. So that's your answer, okay? Or you can simplify it into f prime of x equals 9x plus 6 divided by the absolute value of 3x plus 2. So that is your first solution. Now the second solution that we're going to generate involves expressing this function as a piecewise defined function, okay? This result is also equally correct. So solution two, we're going to write the absolute value function as follows. This is going to be, we know that f of x, which equals the absolute value of 3x plus 2, can be written as plus or minus 3x plus 2. The sign change happens when the argument of the absolute value function changes sign. Okay, so we just have to solve 3x plus 2 equals 0. Solve this for x, and that will tell you where the sign change happens. Okay, so we subtract 2 and divide by 3, we have x equals negative 2/3. All right, so now our function is negative 3x plus 2 when x is less than negative 2/3, and 3x plus 2 when x is greater than or equal to negative 2/3. Okay, so now this is our piecewise defined function. Now what we're going to do is find the derivative of this piecewise defined function. So f prime of x is simply going to be the derivative of the function to the left, which is negative 3x plus 2. The derivative of that is negative 3 when x is less than negative 2/3. And this on the bottom is 3 when x is greater than or equal to negative 2/3. Okay, so this is another possible solution for the derivative of the absolute value of 3x plus 2. Okay, so any of these solutions, you will get full credit if you're asked to find the derivative of this absolute value function. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. And also feel free to post comments in the comment section to let us know what you think about this lesson. More clips can be found on mathgotserved.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.